Good evening, everyone. Time for another silver update. This is the daily chart of silver. You can see we're falling into the evening session here, trading fast and furiously. So we're in a complete panic. Silver's going to zero. All your silver will be worthless. At least that's certainly what they want you to believe. And that, of course, is why they're doing this. So you can see that the volume here that they've created, and we're talking 5 million now. I don't know if that's contracts or not, but it's a huge amount of contracts anyway. So they're literally selling billions and billions and billions and billions of ounces of silver that doesn't exist. And this is a fake market. They're pushing it a little too far, and let me prove that to you. So for those of you who haven't followed the silver market as long as I have, and I've been following the silver market since the mid-1970s, for most of the life of the silver market, probably, let's actually get in here and look at a one-minute view and see how they're doing here. For most of the life of the silver market, you have the spot price. That's the price that most of the coin stores operate off of. And I've done a video in the past about the junk silver. I'm going to try to address that mainly, the old U.S. Silver dimes, quarters, half dollars, dollars, etc. But if you followed the silver market as long as I have, you know that junk generally, for probably 97 or 98% of the time, sells for below spot or around spot. Now, that's why your coin dealers are always looking at the spot price, because a lot of the coin dealers don't expect to turn around and sell their silver to the public, just because that's the nature of that business. There just isn't the kind of walk-in demand. Generally, they lowball the spot price, and then they just take it and dump it on the refiners. And so that spot's very important. And of course, with junk, it's extremely important, because we just don't know how much of that junk is being melted down. Now, I've done the figures in the past. I've done a complete spreadsheet. You can look back in my videos, that where I give a list of all the junk that was ever minted, and it's billions of ounces, but we just don't know how much was melted in the 70s, and we don't know how much has been melted since then. So, but we want to look at the junk silver price. If you listen to my latest, I won't call it a debate, because really the only thing we disagreed about was bitcoins, but my latest roundtable with Chris Duane, we both agreed that one of the best investments you can make probably is the junk silver dimes, just because they're not counterfeitable, and they're clearly recognizable. They're very, very cheap. And Chris brought up the idea that when they run out, and they're going to run out, but when they run out, then it's just going to work its way up the food chain. And that makes perfect sense to me. In fact, I would probably like to recommend on this video that we go ahead and let's just all target those dimes, whether they're Mercury's or Roosevelt's. Let's go ahead and target those, and let's evaporate that thing out of existence. And then just take it up the chain one by one by one. But what we're seeing now, I believe, actually is the beginning of the disconnect between the physical market and the fake paper market that we're looking at right here. Now, let me try to prove that to you. I'm going to start off. We're not going to start at Provident. We're going to go to APMEX to begin with, of course, because APMEX is the big daddy of them all. Now, I want you to note here that they do have these silver bags. They break them down between generic bags and between specific bags. If you buy a generic bag, you don't know if you're getting dimes or quarters or half dollars or whatever you're getting, but you know that you're getting About 715 ounces of silver. That's the thousand face junk bag. Now, if you take this price here, I'm not going to pull up the calculator, but if you take this price, the way you calculate the cost of silver on these junk bags is you just divide whatever the price is by 715. Now, if you do that, it comes with this figure, it comes to above $30. So we're now talking about a $3 premium above spot for junk silver. Now that is unprecedented. And you can see they have 10 left of those. Of the 500 bags, they have 12. They have 92 of the hundreds. You can see it's pretty consistent on this hunter's 2165, so that's actually even higher than that 30 something price, and then it goes down the line. So that's ATMEX. They're not out, but they're charging more than $30 for junk silver. That's a $3 premium for junk, which for 98 to 99% of history has been at or below spot. So that's the beginning of a disconnect. Now, if we go over to Provident, we can see they're all out. They've all got the alert signs. Let's jump over to Gainesville. You can see with that 21,477, that's roughly the 21,500 price. Again, that's 30 plus dollars an ounce for junk silver. And then the last one is going to be Tolving, and you can see that the 90% bags are sold out. The half dollar 90% are sold out. The walking libs are sold out. So the junk is sold out, and the price he was quoting, well, you can see this here. He's quoting what he buys at, and let's get to the generic junk. He's buying at $1.10 above spot. So that is absolutely unheard of for spot to disconnect like that. But that is exactly what you expect to see when you have a fake market. And this is in no doubt in my mind. I don't have a shred of doubt in my mind. I'm 100% certain that this is a fake market. This is a market controlled by central banks and governments who, in the wake of the Cyprus and Euro meltdown, which is on the brink, we're on the very brink of a complete meltdown of the financial system beginning in Europe. It started in Cyprus. The bank runs are starting in the rest of Europe. And of course, this is the most undervalued investment on the face of the earth. It's nearly 50% below its 1979 high. Gold is far above its 1979 high, nearly twice as high. So silver, just on that basis, is 75% undervalued. It's only 25% of what it should be based on, just compared to gold. So this is, as I've said many, many times, this is their Achilles heel. This is why they are attacking. This is why they are selling billions and billions and billions of ounces of silver that does not exist. So the other point that I brought out in my recent videos is that anybody who understands supply and demand, it's really not that complicated. Markets aren't that complicated. When you have an oversupply, and you can go over to Kitco Base Metals and look at those and look at the stocks. Of course, we don't have any real stock figures for silver because they're all fake. But when you look at the base metal stocks, you know that when you have this huge oversupply, then eventually that is going to pressure down the price. It's just it's supply and demand. It's going to get dumped. So the question is if the reason why silver is falling and the reason why prices fall is because there's too much of it, how can we have this rapidly falling price in the face of $3 above spot junk silver? I don't even want to look at the others. So obviously, I can't convince you more than what I've shown you that this is, in fact, a fake market. And the nature of markets, as Rothschild was famous for saying, is that the time to buy is when the blood is running in the streets. Unfortunately for us, there's already a $3 premium above spot, even for the junk coin. So my proposal is, for those of you who want to target those, go ahead and start targeting those silver dimes and the junk bags of dimes, and let's start taking that out, because as they destroy the price here and we buy up those quantities of rare and rarer coins, then the disconnect between their fake market, which is what this is, and the real market, which is physical, will become more and more apparent. And as they force this manipulation in our faces, we will see the disconnect, and then that will be it. That will be the beginning of the end game, as the COMEX is no longer a legitimate pricing mechanism for silver. And we'll talk to you next time.